What's up, guys? So, I want to be explaining in this video my way of modeling is, in personal opinion, so much easier than all the other ways. It's just easier to see, etc. So, we're going to be using a 2015 Dodge Charger that's from the Herc, if I'm not correct. Let's set up my screens quickly. How I normally have it is either left view or top view, and then 3D on the right side. Just my personal preference. Your preference could be a lot different. That's all your guys' choice. Sorry. I'm going to do the basic thing of setting up a light bar. I'm going to use a legacy, I think. Yeah, we'll use a legacy on it. Go ahead and quickly put a legacy on. Lights. Alright, so. It's going to be set up as an extra. So, box is just the collisions I have pre-set up for myself. So, I normally go down to front view when I'm setting up a light bar, just because you can tell. That's obviously humongous for a charge. That should be common sense to know or not. But let's go ahead and put this on. I should be good there. Go here, turn off collisions. Negatory. We just want to make sure those parts are actually on inside the car. That should be good there. Nope. Still not good, really. Modeling is this type of... Like, by the pain in the ass. Good enough. Alright, so, this will be in the description, this legacy, or you can get it in multiple Discords out there. So, for some reason, I have ones. Do I have one? Okay, I have one before absolutely everything. So, I'm just remove all this. My main sirens I normally use for a light bar. Either a 7 and 8 or 2 and 5, just personal preference. Make sure we have collision at the end of this. Oh, okay, we're just going to type it, I guess. Alright, I'm going to select these both. So that's collisions. Now, these are basically as simple as that, ready to go. So, I think the current pattern set up for this is, yeah, just a left-right. We're going to leave it like that. If you guys want to see different parts, I can show you that later down the track. We're going to go on L. Well, we're going to set up the yellows for this. I normally make it to go to L3, so I just select it, copy it. Yeah, create copy, etc. Then I'm gonna select these both, right click, convert to dummy. Then we just convert these to compounds. And then you just grab them and throw them in this box here. This is for the yellows. So I normally do L3. So up to L3, just like that. Then for this one too. Alright, as you can see, that is now done. Simple as that. I'm gonna actually show you the way I set up my dummies in that. So we're going to delete these old ones. So, we create a dummy. It's normally humongous, as you can tell, compared to the look of that light bar. If we move it up here, you can't tell me that's not humongous. So we're going to do the good thing. I scale my dummies down. So when you come here, you'll have dummy nodes. You want to scale them to X, Y, and Z to 0.015. So it should be like that. You'll get used to scaling down sooner than later. Then they go from that to that, so that extremely smaller and so much better looking. So I just try and position it as good as I can. Good enough. Let's get top view, and then we just go ahead and move this dummy, create a copy of the dummy, just so you don't have to recreate another one and do the whole thing or the whole process again. Just more effort that you don't need to deal with. Alright, so now that's done, we just want to go select, figure out what one's what. So this is number 2, you can tell by the dummy and the thing disappearing. Go on there, please, thank you. Now we're just going to rename this to Siren 2, Siren 5. You can tell this is front facing for the vehicle, because the white at the front, as you can tell. So now we're just keeping top view, select, and I'm going to keep my X, Y, and Z on. So I'm going to deselect my dummies by holding down left control. So, left control, and you just basically select them like you would go to select the normal thing. Simple as that. Display, reset to parent. You'll know when they've done properly. If they want to. Okay, well, good one. But you'll know because the axes will move. Axes are these little L's. That kind of common sense to know. So, I'll go up here again. Now, we want to come here, turn off pivot. I'm not sure exactly why, but I know that if you don't do it, it doesn't work. I'm going to scale mine down to 0.1 or 0.1. depends on how you want to differentiate the wording. So it's going to go very small. Very hard to see, actually. So that's how I like my lights. Then I'm just going to create more copies. So go to L3. Simple as that. Now when you want to just go like this. Na-na-na-na-na. Sorry, 5. Sorry, 2. Etc. Just download these quickly. Great. Now, since that's done, we want to go ahead and just make sure mine has show all. I'm going to put the sirens and the siren glass all in extra one. And I just keep make sure it's normally like this. Extra one collision, then the siren glass one, the collision. And I normally just like to mine more as good as possible. And we're just going to throw this right to the tippy top because I feel like that's the best position for it. As you can tell, light bars on it looks good. Now we want to come up to the material browser. Why is it unused materials? It's just going to delete them. This shouldn't be on your model, I hope. Alright, so we're going to actually make sure, because in-game, this is going to be shiny. So, if the vehicle mesh, not all of them, but this one I normally recommend. So the generic and the mesh, I'm going to change the material too. So, as you can tell, it looks so much better. You want to grab this light's emissive and put it all the way to the top, on the left of the body shell. So, always goes up top, so it's above the glass is what they call it. Now we're just going to quickly call this charger, and we're going to go ahead and export the vehicle, and I will be back in once I've exported it and got it set up. Just give me a minute. Alright, so we're back here, got everything set up. I'm actually going to make sure when you're having your texture directory, aka your YTD, always put in your textures, so it should be 2 for a legacy, so simple as that. Always want to double check, so we don't need this open nor this open since I got the textures. We want to wait for this to load. Now we go and open this, and you can tell it's working. If you actually look into the light bar, you'll see the tiny lights here, over here. Very small compared to the light bar itself. So that's how I personally look at it. And so all these metas in that here, all will be here. So if we look in the vehicle's meta, you got just your based stuff. So this is called Charger. So we want to make sure the model name and the car variation name is Charger. So these have to all be named to this specific stream name which your vehicle is. So I'm going to set it up to how I normally would. So now we're going to do here, 2015 Dodge Charger. Now we just change this to here. And here. So now you want to 100% make sure for your vehicle to work properly, you want to make sure the ID for this is set to a specific ID. It can be something above, I think it's 30. So we're going to go 88. And then we're just going to copy this, and then we're going to go to siren settings here, and put it to 88. So, now, I will quickly put, I'm going to run into game quickly, and I'm going to show you what happens if you don't set up the car calls, or if you don't set them up at all. So I'll be back 1 minute. Alright, so now in game, make sure you're going to spawn it in now with the name, so mine's Charger. Right, we want to load. Right, so this is what it's currently looking like. This is because I didn't set up the car course. So now, what I'm going to do, jump out of game, close my server. Now we're going to go into the car course, and I'm going to keep this file in the bottom, or in the description. So we're going to go here, edit. So these are delta values. These are based off the way a vehicle is rotated, or lighting is rotated. So let me bring up this. These are what deltas. So you have left side runners or something. This is the deltas you would do when you rotate them. So what I'm going to do, since I made it an extra, sometimes it does this, I don't know why, we're going to make it the back version. So we're going to go copy this. Now you're going to remember what siren you use for the light bar. So I use siren 2. So never touch the rotation, you don't need to do this, just the flashiness. So we're going to put the delta for flashiness here. It's going to be 3 point blah 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 blah. Then come to 5 and put it here 2. So that should be ready. Now we're going to go in game and we're going to double check it. We'll be back in 1 minute. Alright, so we're in game. I'm going to spawn it back in, same spawn in prior. So, as you can tell, light is perfectly fine now, just flashing. That's how the sequencer is and how it's personally set up. So, if I change it to nighttime, the dummies are actually on the roof. If you face the front, you will see them, but if you're rear, you won't see them. So, as you can see, this is a dummy, this little flashing piece here. So, it's simple. It's got all front ambience, as you can obviously tell and see. So it's very simple to set up a light bar. I will make a whole, quite a few other tutorials on how to set up differential things. but this is the base one for now. So if you did enjoy, make sure you hit that subscribe button and like, and join my Discord if you have any issues and or questions. Enjoy, guys.